the city of Whittier, it's Marty's Corner. Tonight, join Marty and his guests. Comedian Tanya Moon. A ball fashion show from Monica Lee Designs. Rock band Tom Racer. And Whittier resident Jebediah Lopez. I'm Tony Ridley. It's Saturday night. It's the 8 o'clock hour. It's time for our host, a former dancer on the Real Don Steel Show, Marty Shield. Hey!
Marty's Corner. Hi, everybody. I'm your host, Marty Shields. I'm the Dr. Laura of Public Access Television. That's who I am. That's right. Nobody's watching tonight. Welcome to Marty's Corner. We've been gone for a while. We're now doing our show here, live from Studio One in the city of Whittier. Can you big round of applause for Whittier? Thank you, Whittier. Tim Keeler, all the guys over here at Channel 20. It's been a while, as I said, since I've done our show. It's probably been about a year, I guess, since we did Marty's Corner. And of course, I've turned 40. I'm 40 years old now. And I used to have a nice little six pack, and I have a big keg going here. So I'm getting old here. A big keg. Found something interesting about myself. I'm being told to go back up into the light. Is that good? On the carpet? How's that? Is that good? We're live, ladies and gentlemen. We're live, as you can tell. Yeah, close enough. Anyhow, what I was going to tell you was one of the things I did when I was off for a year, I actually found out some interesting things about my genealogy. As I was looking through my records of who I came from, I found out that I was a 16th Polish and a 32nd Shiawassee Indian. I'm what they know as a totem pole. Totem pole. 2, 3, 4. No, I don't think so. Okay. Has anyone been watching the Olympics? The Olympics, anybody? Anyway, Olympics, huh? The Olympics on NBC? Now, apparently NBC is getting some heat about that. As you all know, Sydney, Australia is like 18 hours difference than Los Angeles. So everything we're seeing on NBC is like, it's delayed, way delayed. In fact, just found out last night that Hitler would not shake Jesse Owens' hand. That's how late. That's how late. No? Anyhow. You ever hear any Taco Bell people, anybody, huh? Taco Bell's in the news. There we go. Taco Bell's in the news, as we all know. Apparently some of the ingredients are using some of their tacos. I guess some of the corn grain is only used for horses or something. So a little concerned about that. Apparently the spokesman from Taco Bell, when asked, you know, is there any problem with the meat, he said, no. 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 2, 3, 4. Oh, it's going to be a rough night tonight. One of the interesting, these ingredients in the tacos, I guess, kind of make you have like hallucinations. That's right, hallucinations. Some of the people who are eating these tacos are seeing and hearing their dogs talk, little chihuahuas. 2, 3, 4. Do we have any Dennis? Oh no, please. Do we have any Dennis Rodman fans in the audience? Dennis Rodman, anybody? Huh? Anybody care? No, nobody cares. Dennis Rodman. Apparently, Dennis Rodman has his own website now. If you log on to Dennis Rodman's website, you can watch what the goings on at his beach house. You see that? Live? I guess the website is www.bfd.com, huh? BFD?
I like it.
Oh, thank you. Okay, well, the drummer liked it.
Thank you.
Ah, heck with it. As we all know, the elections are coming up this year, and George Bush got himself in a little hot water recently. Apparently, he actually called a newspaper writer for the New York Times an a-hole over the live microphone. You see that in the news? And I guess the Republicans are kind of making a spin on that. They're saying, you know what? We can finally prove that George does read. George does read. Is this rehearsal? I mean, okay. And one more thing. Apparently the CIA has been nice to announce this. They've actually celebrated their 53rd anniversary. 53rd anniversary. The thing was, they didn't tell anybody. Nobody knew. Man! Where are the crickets? And one more thing before I go out. The city of West Covina, we have a couple of guys on the crew who are actually from the city of West Covina. They just passed a new law. And the thing about West Covina is they actually took our show off the air, if you didn't know that. That's right. We were banned in West Covina. That's right. Banned in West Covina. That's right. Now, the thing about West Covina is like, apparently they passed this new law where they're banning wild and exotic animals in the city. So we're going to be kicking off our co-host, Frank. See? Believe it or not, we have a good show for you here. Our 59th show. 59, count on 59, huh? 59 shows here in Marty's Corner. Now, we're supposedly going to have a comedian on named Tanya Moon, and she hasn't showed up. Is that right? She hasn't showed up yet? So we're not going to talk about her. We do have some nice ladies down from city of Whittier. Almost said West Covina. I'm thinking about those exotic animals again. City of Whittier. They'll be doing some fashion designs, some fall fashions for you. Monica Lee Designs is here tonight, huh? Monica Lee Designs are here on the show. We have a group here to my left who will be playing all throughout the night, and they'll be doing two feature songs for us that slog recording artist. Tom Racer is here tonight. Tom Racer is here. Gentlemen. And we have a special treat. We actually found, some of you know, the city of Whittier was actually founded by the Quakers back in the 1880s. And we actually found the last living Quaker here in the city of Whittier. And he'll be on tonight. Jebediah Lopez is here tonight. Jebediah Lopez. The top 9 list and lots more. Don't go away. Guys, could you please get us out of here? Let's go. Channel 20 in the city of Whittier as my first co-host. He's our own little Pokemon, Frank Atencio, ladies and gentlemen. Frank Atencio! We did want to say that the first part of the show is going to be sponsored by Anna Nicole Smith. And I guess it's going to be like sponsored for...
the next 30,000 years.
Next 30,000 years. So thank you, Anna Nicole, for the...
So I want to drop off my cable bill.
Oh, later on in the show you can drop that off.
Okay, thanks.
We haven't seen you for a whole year. What have you been doing?
I was in jail.
You're in jail?
Yeah, I was working there, actually.
Oh, okay.
No joke, I was just working there.
Oh, okay. I wanted to make sure. So,
that wasn't funny, man.
So, again, we haven't done the show in about a year, so we're kind of getting our bearings right. In fact, one of the things we realized was, look at this, huh?
We got to get new furniture. I got a rocking chair here.
You got a rocking chair, so we're going to go ahead and fix that in the next show. Those of you who have watched us for the last 7 years know that we do a segment here on Marty's Corner called the Top 9 List. And the Top 9 List on Marty's Corner, which is is compiled by our home office in beautiful Baldwin Park. Anybody from Baldwin Park? Okay, good. Nobody.
We're so far away now.
Not
from
a soul from Baldwin Park. Our Top 9 List. Okay, we haven't done the show in a whole year here on Marty's Corner, so what we decided to do is take a look at the reasons why we haven't done a show. If you could go bring that up, please, okay, and we have a little drum roll, please. Thank you, sir. Just keep drumming. Top 9 excuses for not doing a show for a year. Number 9 was on short list to replace Kathy Lee Gifford. Number 8 on our list got some real bad career advice from Gary Coleman. 7 spent months downloading music from Napster. 6 had bad reaction to Mexican colonic. Oh. 5 Gary Coleman stole my Buick. 4 on our list, devastated by the cancellation of Suddenly Susan. 3 stuck on a desert island with 15 idiots. 2 worked as Keanu Reeves' butt double on The Matrix. And the 1 reason is, became a soccer mom! Yay! And that's why we haven't done a show in a year.
We were writing those.
It can't get any worse. We're just going as we go, as you can tell. One of the things I did, because I said, some of you who have watched the show know that for years, me and Frank had been in a band together. And during this year we had off, it allowed me to go ahead and pursue some other things I wanted to do. And actually, I cut a record. And I think we actually found that
in our archives. So if you could go and bring up the album that I did, look at your monitors here in the studio audience, and all you people at home, look at your TV sets.
No, don't look at your TV sets.
So if you bring that up, please. Here it is. Oh, we go.
That's a computer screen.
That's a computer screen, but I'm sure momentarily, there I am, Marty Shields, Trinidad Express, huh?
That's right.
Yeah. Isn't that great? Yeah. Yeah. But one of the things that we also found out was a lot of the guys here on the crew during their time off also did some albums. Here's one from our director, John and Frank. John Gar says, Polka Blast and his Fricassee. Oh, it was gone. It was gone before I could read it.
We released it.
There is his Fricassee Mayhem Orchestra, and it says, Sheep Shears and Vaseline. That's the name of the album there.
We found it pick and save throughout the
That's valley. True. And some people here on our cast and crew also did albums they didn't know about. If we could go ahead and take a look at that. Here's our audio guy, Pat Wartink. It's Pat T. Cake. And featuring Pat Wharton, of course, that's got the Parents Advisory Board symbol. That's Pat.
And his sons, too.
That's his sons back there. That's Pat. There's Pat right there. Thank you, Pat. And we have some more for
well,
our
guys
fabulous
behind
crew.
Him, though.
If we could go and take a look at those real quick. As you can tell, we're going as we go. Is that right?
Oh,
there's our TD guy, Tim Keeler's baseball's greatest organ music, Tim's happy organ. There's Tim right there, Timmy. Thank you, Tim. Great job.
Who are those guys back there?
Go Quakes. There's somebody waving back there. The next one we have, go ahead anytime you're ready to give me that next one for our cast and crew.
Anytime
we're ready. I know we're killing time here because there's our cameraman Andy Paravici and Essence of Andy Pure Magic. Isn't that beautiful, Andy? There's Andy. Hey,
thank you, Andy.
Oh, thank you. Beautiful. She's not really. Okay. And the next one we have, let's go to the next one, if we could please, in the control room. As I'm watching the monitor and nothing's happening.
Are you looking at me, man?
I'm looking at you now. Here we go. Carson Bell doing his Carson City Blues. Ladies and gentlemen, Carson Bell.
There's Carson right there.
Carson, there he is. Carson. Hey, thank you, Carson.
Who are those people standing behind
I don't know. We have another one here. If we can go and bring that one up here as we're stretching for time. Our comedian hasn't showed up yet, so hopefully if we do this long
and
enough.
And wisely so.
The next one we can, if we can go and bring that up in the control room, please. Anytime you're ready. And there's, of course, there's our very own Scott Fuller.
What does he do?
See, there's Scott right there. What a great shot,
what
Scott.
What does he do on our show, though?
He stands there and does it. That's Scott.
Oh, that's right.
Good shot, Scott.
He just stares
okay,
at
and
me.
We have some more going, so let's go and bring those other ones up as we go, as we're stretching out. We're stretching out, and here we go. And there's Tony, a tone deaf. Says, there's a gat in my pants. That's the name of his. There's Tony, very nice Tony.
With a gat in his pants.
There's a gat in his pants. We have any more? I think we might have a couple more here.
A good surgeon in
Hollywood. I think we have about. We have way more than I thought we had, but let's keep going as we're trying to stretch this bit out. And we have three more. I'm sorry, I'm being told by three. Here's one. Here's Maria del Carmen impersonates Carmen Miranda, the passion fruit. And of course, that's Carmen, our floor manager, Carmen. Thank you. Carmen, you're looking great, okay?
Yeah, I love her beard.
And our last one, I think we got a little glimpse of that before. We have one for our last camera operator, Jack Rodriguez, Jack CD. Let's get a shot of Jack. I think there it is. There's Jack Spratt Rodriguez and the compadres, huh? Jack Rodriguez. And that's all of them, huh? Mercifully so, that's all of them.
And that, folks, is how not to do a television show. We just put that on right now to show you how not to put on television.
We're going
show.
As we go.
And now we're going to start the real show.
We do have a good show for you, believe it or not, here in Marty's Corner. The next segment, after we go to the commercial break, we're going to be bringing on Monica Lee Designs. They're going to be doing a fall fashion show. So don't go anywhere. Guys, can you please get us out of here? Let's go! Come on! About seven people in the audience who are making them clap real loud and scream, and they want no part of this. As I mentioned at the beginning of the show, we have a fashion show for here in Marty's Corner. A young lady and her sister, I guess, have started a fashion design center here in the city of Whittier. and they'll be on to talk a little bit about how they got this thing started, and also going to be doing a little fashion show here with some fall fashions. Can you please give a warm welcome to Monica and Tracey? Come on, ladies! Come around here. Nice to meet you. Thank you. Let me have a seat right here. Have a seat right there. Tracey, good to see you. Have a seat right there. Watch yourself. These microphones are deadly. Yeah. You just clip those right on, and you're all set.
There you go.
Thank you, ladies.
Let's see.
Oh, it's okay. It's fine because it's not going to break. It's stainless steel.
All right.
Welcome to the show. You ladies are sisters. Who's the older of the two, if you don't mind me asking?
Tracy's
the older one. And you started the company Monica Lee Designs.
Yes.
Where'd the idea come from?
Me.
Oh, okay. Well, that works out well. And you're the Monica Lee of Monica Lee.
I'm the Monica Lee of Monica Lee Designs.
So where did the idea come from?
I've been designing for 9 years in the fashion industry. Well, plus some other things. But the fashion industry, as you know, is insane.
Yes.
But I like to design. So we started our own company.
How long have you been doing this now?
A year.
A year now?
Yeah.
Now, where do you fit in this part, Tracy?
I just kind of came along there. I do
a lot of the graphics.
Clerical actually, and I have a little input to some of the design.
Okay.
We're starting a second line, and
called Mowear for MLD. Yeah.
Now, what is Mowear? I'm not familiar with that.
Mowear.
That
is
that's
Groovewear
a,
is the term.
What is it called?
It's sort of a skateboard thing.
Like punk, skateboard punk kind of thing? Or?
Yeah, so the main bulk of the business is the Monica Lee Designs because it's higher priced. It keeps it going.
So this is priced where? This is like really...
It's about $900 per suit.
Oh, jeez. I mean, I have no idea if that's a lot for me. I paid about $5 for this tie, you can tell. So.
I paid $20 for my shoes.
So I think we're ready to go with the fashion show. So if you could bring that music up into the studio here and let us know what we're looking at. Ladies, when you're ready, tell us what we're looking at, girls.
That's what I'll do. Here's Valerie. Valerie's wearing our drac jacket. Well, let's see all the girls first. Valerie is wearing our drac jacket. It's made out of plastic, fantastic flowers fabric. You can see the reverse of the fabric in the vents of the jacket and the big cuffs. Jacket's also lined with a beautiful herringbone, cream-colored herringbone lining. And let's see what Megan's wearing. Megan is wearing a beautiful long dress made from sexy sheer black fabric. It's got elegant ivory braiding around the neckline and the plunging back. Pretty side slit. A nice evening gown. Thank you, Megan. And here is Jamie. Jamie's in our boudoir ensemble.
This is a special design.
Yes.
Now, what's special about this design?
It's not really for going out of the house, per se.
Yes.
Oh,
it's for lounging in style.
Lounging in style.
Lounging in style.
That's pretty high cut there, isn't it?
There,
yeah.
Yes.
I'm just noticing that.
Marty's a... Can we mention who our fabulous model here is?
Not right yet, because I get myself in trouble with grandma. Okay.
Let's see. Well, I think Marty set it all for this outfit. It's very sexy, but it's very elegant,
but
very
beautiful.
But it's
a get yourself in trouble with grandma outfit.
There
yes.
we go.
You have to wear it appropriately.
Okay.
All right, thank you.
Thank you,
Jamie.
Thank you, ladies, okay? Now, again, the ladies are all getting changed as we're talking, so we're going to talk a little bit more about the actual company. Tell me a little about your inspiration. What got you going involved in this? What's your inspiration?
What got me going in fashion design? I like the drawing aspect of it and the creative side. I've always enjoyed painting and that kind of thing, but I didn't really want to be a poor artist. Sorry!
I know the feeling, so.
But I did fashion design. So where I draw my inspiration?
Yeah.
Well, God, you know.
Just where you can find it, I mean.
You know, oddly enough, I've always enjoyed science, mathematics.
So where does that tie in with all fashion? Because they're like different
two
lobes of the brain or
the
something.
Spectrum.
Yeah.
I know. No, I like equations. You have biomorphic shapes, and I like to see a lot of curves and things like that. And I translate it into clothes.
Okay, we have some more ladies to come. Let's go and bring them up here.
All right.
Music up in the booth here. What are we looking at?
Here's Valerie. Valerie is wearing our long jacket. It's made out of gorgeous for fall fabric. This is a really fun and funky jacket. It's got stripes going every which way. It's very cute, and it's worn over an asymmetrical neck dress. This is a matte jersey fabric. Very sexy. Very fun. It's good for going out. Looks like a work dress, maybe. You could wear that to the office, I'm sure, with that nice jacket. Thank you, Valerie.
Thank you, Valerie. Oh, thank you.
And here's Misty. Misty is in our lovely sheer fabric jacket. It's got platinum flowers on it. Features a pretty stand-up collar, flowing lines. Underneath is a high-neck halter.
Genuine plastic.
Yes. Yes, this is a very special outfit because of the fabric. This is a plastic fabric. It's very comfortable, fun. You can, I don't know, it's neat. Stands up very well. The pants are are slim silhouette pants with a vented bottom. This outfit was made especially for Misty. When we work with clients.
You do custom designs also?
Yes. Misty sat with Monica and told her what she wanted. Monica knows Misty. She gets to know a little bit of the person's personality that she's designing for. So the outfit comes out really showing who you are. It's pretty much
custom.
Yeah, the customer almost designs it themselves in a way.
They have so much input.
Actually, I'll go visit a client at their house, say a politician, and I just get a good feeling for their personality because they're not quite sure what they want, so I just design a sketch for them.
Sure.
And it comes out looking like.
Thank you very much, Misty. We appreciate it.
Thank you, Misty.
And what do we have now?
There's Megan again.
Okay.
She is in our sheer burgundy plaid jacket. It's a sheer fabric with a plaid pattern. It's got a really pretty vented back. I think that's called a trapeze vent in the back. Makes it swing really well. And underneath is a simple matte jersey slip dress. It's another fun outfit. These are nice for daytime. You could wear them going out too, I suppose. I like the patterns.
This is more of a fun, sort of a fantasy type of
Yeah, thing. With the jacket.
If so Megan swings open her arm, you can see the sheerness of the plaid.
There we go.
It's
a pretty outfit.
Very nice.
Thank you, Megan.
Thank you, Megan. Now, what kind of clientele do you have? I mean, primarily, are they, you know, openly mobile people that are looking for fashions? Or?
Yeah, they are. They usually tend to be politicians, actually. I don't know how I fell into that.
So politicians are wearing this kind of stuff?
More like Megan, what Megan has
okay.
on. Or they'll
Not the slit up the thing with
No,
they may wear the boudoir thing at home.
What do we have here?
I like this. This is our orange, the Asian influenced dress.
Yeah, most of the fabrics are from Europe, so they're a little bit more vibrant than you usually see. A little bit more higher price. This is something that you can wear to a club, you can wear it out to dinner. They are a little bit more artistic or a little bit more outgoing than a lot of lines that you see. That's a lot of the feedback that I get. So sometimes I have to tone it down for a specific customer because they want to wear it, but they don't want to look so avant-garde, I guess.
Do you wear most of your fashions?
I do wear them, actually. I have nothing on tonight. That's probably designed. So.
Is this I do, don't I?
But Tracey does.
Oh, so she's also wearing something weird. Okay, I'll stand.
Thank you, Valerie.
Thank you, Valerie.
Here's
and next
again.
Up here again.
This is Monica's version of the little black dress.
The famous nice, little black dress.
Little black dress. A little simple matte jersey dress, but we added the smoke-colored beading on the front.
On the princess scene.
That's a real cute little thing. And I was thinking earlier today this would also be cute with boots. You could tone it down. Cute little outfit.
You're saying, how much would something like this cost if someone wanted to buy this?
This would retail for about $500 because of the fabric. And very simple, so you know, it just depends on what client is buying.
You had mentioned you have some incredible fabrics actually, some from Galanos. Tell us a story about how you got hooked up with some of the fabrics you use.
What kinds of fabrics
you
use? Yeah. I use a lot of silk from Italy and France. And Galanos, I was able to meet through the fashion industry through friends, and when he was closing his couturier, I called him and he invited me to come down and look at his fabrics. And buy them. So that was a neat thing. Some of the fabrics are 30 to 40 years old, and I was able to buy them on the bolt still and cut them as if they were new. And so even though they're new designs, they're out of vintage fabrics. A lot of them are.
Are they rare fabrics?
They are very rare. Galanos paid probably $100 to $150 a yard for them, the fabrics, and then he sold them to me for about a third of the price.
Do you do your own sewing, or do you actually bring someone in to do some of these?
I do some of the sewing, but I usually contract out.
Can you do that?
Yeah.
Okay. Jamie, thank you so much. Jamie, thank you so much for your help. I know these girls are changing, like they're like running down the hallways. And I know they're like putting their hairs on, everything else. So go ahead.
This is one of the vintage fabrics we talked about,
Galanos,
correct? This
yeah,
is a Galanos fabric.
The fabric, and that's a silk. That's one of the Italian silks.
So what's this go for? I mean, I have no clue. I have no clue. How much is this going to cost?
About $800.
$800.
Yeah.
And it's a sheer fabric over
and
you know,
people,
ice
people
blue.
Do the laughing.
Yeah, is that pretty much a standard price, or is that like
for that kind of quality? I mean, no one can.
Is it the fabric? Is that what it actually?
Yeah, you could do it in a different fabric, and it would actually look a little different.
But, okay.
In a less expensive fabric.
Well, the other
fabric.
Thing that the audience can't see, but I think only the industry would know, is the quality of the sewing as well. It's couture, which it has really nice. Construction to it, so it won't fall apart in 2 weeks.
How long have you been in the industry now? I mean, I know you went to school and stuff.
9 years.
9 years?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. We also have another model up here. Now, this is this like crushed velvet? What is this?
That's mm-hmm. velvet.
This is velvet. This is really pretty. I'm just picking up on that on the cameras or not. That's beautiful. What are we looking at?
Yes.
That is a gown that I made for actually New Year's Eve.
That is cool.
For a date that fortunately didn't work out.
Oh, I'm sorry
so
to hear that.
Is that
bad memories for you?
No.
It was
beautiful.
All the piping around this is
all
beautiful.
That's actually hand beading.
That is hand beading?
That I worked on
that
till the wee hours
the
of the evening.
So you also do part of the actual creation as far as?
Some of the work.
That is
some
just
of the
beautiful.
Detail that needs to be done. And can you show us your little dress underneath? It's very pretty.
Okay.
It's got a nice little sheer.
Yeah, that is
peeking
just,
out from behind. From underneath.
Oh, there is a.
And in the pleat in the back, you can see that.
Beautiful.
That dress. Sheer fabric that's underneath.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Megan.
Good attention to detail.
Outstanding.
Thank
you so much,
Megan.
Okay. Like I said, we are making these women rush and throw things together in the last second, but that's part of the fashion industry. Have you done any shows?
Have I done any shows?
Yeah.
Yes, too.
And how was that?
They were good.
Not as crazy as this show, I'm guessing. Probably a little more.
No, you know what? They are crazy.
I mean, backstage people flying and stuff.
They
and
are crazy.
You always see those behind the scenes things with the models getting all crazy, and is that pretty much the way it is?
Yes, it is.
So how do you keep your sanity? Just go ahead and just...
I sort of don't show up until really late.
Purposely, or are you just...
On purpose.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, I know they're doing last minute adjustments as we speak, and because we are a G-rated show, we want to make sure that all the proper adjustments are made beforehand. Are we okay? Are we good to go yet? No? I mean, I can get up and do a little fashion modeling here with my ensemble.
Yeah, Marty.
Well, let me go real quick.
Marty, jacket.
Let me go and tell you what I'm wearing. Go ahead, you guys describe me real quick.
Now, Marty is wearing the classic Levi jean with the, what is that, a suede front vest? Logan green shirt.
Tie.
And there's that $5 tie we all love.
Yes. The wallet in the hand look, love that.
Yeah, there you go. The wallet in the pocket is a fine treatment. The perfect clothes to wear when you're hosting a television show.
Okay, sorry. Okay, still some time
there.
All right, what do we have now? Sorry.
This is Jamie again, and this is an asymmetrical 40s dress.
Which means what exactly? I'm not good at math.
I think it threw in a... this is a symmetrical halter gown.
Symmetrical halter gown.
Which means what exactly, though? I mean,
Is
the cut makes it asymmetrical?
It's weight out.
No, actually,
the way
it's
weighed out, the front and the back. It's symmetrical.
It's symmetrical.
So I mean, the way the lines
it has,
are.
Rhinestones in the back with the frog detail.
And big open back and shoulders. Shoulders are always nice.
Yeah.
Shoulders are good.
Aren't they nice?
The band likes shoulders, don't you guys, huh?
Yeah,
see the band.
Yeah.
Shoulders are big. Shoulders are big. Outstanding.
That's one of the Galanos fabrics.
Do we have any more actual ladies? Is this going to...
This is our last one.
Can you bring the good ladies out? Yes. All the girls, all the models, please come on. I'm going to go talk to them real quick. Hold on. I'm going to the handheld. The guys in the boat. Hey, come up here. Come on up here. I'm tall. I can stand in front of all of them. Real quick, we'd like to have the ladies introduce themselves. First of all, on my far right.
I'm Megan.
Here for Megan one time, guys. Come on. We're subjecting you to this. And to my immediate left is?
Misty.
Here for Misty, huh? Thank you. And way in the front here?
Val.
Val. Thank you so much, Val. And on the far left, you just made it in time, you are?
Jamie.
Thank you, Jamie. Outstanding.
All right, why don't you go, ladies, move out of the way so I can say goodbye to my guests. Just go and step out there real quick. We need to go away again. Do you have a website or a number they can contact you if they want to get a hold of you?
We have a number that we can be contacted at.
And what number is that?
That's 562-907-4114.
And it's here in the city of Whittier, correct?
Yeah.
Whereabouts exactly?
Uptown,
beautiful Uptown Whittier.
Beautiful Uptown Whittier.
Again, we want to thank all the people for coming down, all of our models, and of course, Monica and Tracey from Mockley Designs. Yay! Stay right here, ladies. This place is falling apart. We need to go away for a 3-minute break. We'll be right back, guys. Get us out of here. It can't get any worse. We're back here on a live Saturday night to Marty's Corner. The gentlemen off to my left have been nice enough to come down. They've been sitting through the first 40 minutes of our show, and they're going to be doing two featured songs. These gentlemen, I guess, are going to be doing some dates later on. They're going to be talking about that. We have the only CD, but I guess they just came out of the studio. They're going to release another one in just a few weeks. Slog recording artist, can you please give a warm welcome to Tom Racer. Guys, take it away!
I was walking by your house and I didn't find anything except what I wanted to find, which is what, I don't know, you'll have to remind. I know it wasn't good because I couldn't stop my heart from racing. Racing, retracing all the thoughts that I'd had. Replaying the good and the bad till one was the other and they're all the same. Either way, I had to find out how to put an end to that stupid game. Will it go away? Will it go away? Will it go away? Will it go away? Wondering myself if it'd ever be worth it. You know all the pain, the hope, and the love in my time. I gave you an inch and you took off with the horn. I stood in front of your house for that split second. I realized with what I don't really want to find, I actually may sympathize. And so I walk away knowing you don't have my nuclear array. Will it go away? Will it go away? Will it go away? Will it go away? Make it go away, make it go away.
You guys got to loosen up. Ladies and gentlemen, real quick, let's introduce the band. First of all, Eric, who do you have on bass guitar?
Why don't you let him tell you?
Mike Elliott, bass guitar.
Thank you, Mike.
Okay, and over here on the other guitar?
Aaron Emil.
Eric Emil. And way in the back, always say hi to the drummers. In the back is?
Jared Summerell. Yeah.
Like the tongue, Jared. Okay, again, this is your new CD, well, actually your only CD. This is the first one you did. Now, how old is this one, Eric?
We did that one in summer '97.
But but you just recorded a new one, you were saying.
Yeah, we just finished recording our new record. It's going to be out, you know, in a little bit. It's called TR. We just finished.
Yeah. Now where can they actually buy this CD when it comes out?
I don't know, a couple months. You know.
But where at, though?
I mean, where? Anywhere. Yeah. Stores.
Oh, really? Stores?
Yeah.
I wasn't sure what the story was. You have a gig coming up, I guess, about a week away? Where are you guys be playing at?
A week from yesterday. Friday the 6th at the Dragonfly in Hollywood.
Where's the camera? You look at the camera and tell us right away. Where is it?
Friday, October 6th at the Dragonfly Lounge in Hollywood, California.
That was blatant. How long have you guys been together now?
Probably about 5 years.
That's a long time for you guys. You have a website or something? I didn't mean anything else but that. You have a website or something you want to give out real quick?
TomRacer.net.
TomRacer. Again, you're going to be doing one more song. What song is that going to be?
It's called You Make Me Want to Kill You.
Oh, great. Ladies and gentlemen, one more time. Tom Racer, guys, take it away!
Tonight, yeah, yeah, yeah. I'll kill
blood.
I'm in Tom Racer, huh? We need to go away for a 3-minute break, guys. Could you please get us out of here? Do anything you want. Let's go! Getting larger as we talk. As we mentioned at the beginning of the show, we're coming from Whittier now here on Channel 20, and we actually located, actually we got to this place, a gentleman who's the last living Quaker of Whittier. Can you please give a warm welcome to Jebediah Lopez? Jebediah, come on out! Jebediah! Jebediah? That's a microphone. You can hook that up to your right here.
Thank you.
Thank you, Marty. It's a microphone.
Goes right in there.
I guess pointing up, huh?
Yeah, pointing up is good.
Thank you for coming down, Jebediah.
Oh, my pleasure. Thank you, Marty. You're looking mighty plain there.
I
guess I'm here to fix this.
No, we didn't actually come down here to fix this. We wanted to talk a little bit about being the last living Quaker in the city of Whittier. How long have you been a Quaker?
All my life. I was born a Quaker.
You were born a Quaker. And we want to thank you for coming down on this weekend because we know it's your people's high holy days, Rosh Hashanah, this weekend.
I think you're mistaking us with the Jews. It's their holiday. We're Quakers.
Oh, you're Quakers? So how many wives do you have?
Actually, I'm divorced, and I only had one wife. I think you're mistaking us for the Mormons. They have multiple wives, or they used to before it became illegal or something like that.
And you're a Quaker?
I'm a Quaker, yeah. We only have the one spouse. Well, in my case, I'm hoping for two, but...
But you do, like, one thing I know about Quakers, you don't have any kind of electrical devices in your house.
Hey, there are chicks here.
I know, yeah.
What?
Don't talk to the girls.
No, I have a bunch of electrical devices. I have an electric razor, which I never use, but, television set, stereo system, yeah. I think you're thinking of the Amish. They don't have electrical devices. No, we're Quakers. We do have electrical devices.
You're a Quaker.
Yeah, we're different from them.
Let's start this over again. So you're a Quaker, so you do drive a buggy.
Yeah, I do now because Gary Coleman stole my Buick.
Okay. Now we have monitors here in the studio. Do you have any problem with this? I mean, are you afraid that's going to steal your soul or anything like that?
No. I think you're thinking of the Native American stereotype.
Uh-huh. But you do live in Whittier.
Well, through the witness protection program,
yeah.
I actually live in Roland Heights now.
So you're not in Whittier? Why are you not living in Whittier?
Well, one night I had too much elderberry wine and they caught me hammering out in public, if you know what I mean.
Oh! Jesus.
Oh, this is my agent who got me this job.
Well, he's looking really... Now, you come from a large family, I've been told.
Thank you. Yeah, there's about 16 or 17 of us.
16 or 17?
Yeah, plus the band.
Plus the band? So you're all just one big happy family?
Yeah. Pretty much.
Yeah. I know you're a little bit nervous about coming down here.
Well, I feel kind of weird, all these chicks like standing there looking at me, giggling. This guy sitting next to me.
So what are Quakers known for?
A lot of things. Quaker oats.
Yeah, Quaker
started
oats.
It's pretty good, but steady diet, that sucks.
Yeah.
Quaker State Motor Oil.
Sure.
San Bernardino Quakes.
Oh, yeah, it's a baseball team.
That's a bunch of our guys. Yeah.
Yeah.
The Whittier Quake.
The Whittier Quake?
Yeah. That was us.
No.
It was a big rumble.
A big rumble?
Yeah, big factional.
So you're responsible for the Whittier earthquake?
Well, we don't really talk about it that much. We're still in litigation about that.
Oh, I don't want to get in trouble or anything.
Yeah.
Well, we're so sorry. We obviously screwed this up because we didn't know that you were a Quaker. We thought you were an Amish. In fact, Monica, who was on earlier, was is actually Amish. And
she is?
Yeah, well, come on here real
the
quick.
The chick was in
yeah,
here?
Yeah, Monica, come on. This is, Michael, thank you. Now, you're Amish.
Oh, did I say Quaker? Yeah. I meant Amish. I'm Amish.
You're Amish?
Yeah.
You're Amish?
Yeah.
Let's get the hell out of here. Let's go.
Go get out of here. Ladies and gentlemen, Jebediah Lopez, get him out of here. We need to get out of here for Marty's Corner. See us next time on Channel 20. Guys from Tom Racer, get us out of here. Let's go. Come on.
Lovely lady.